Fact, you have a greater covenant, a greater blessing. Fact, you have that authority. But also a fact, you must be led of the Spirit, not frivolity. We have a capacity in God that is so far beyond our normal thinking that it takes the mind of Christ operative in you to even begin to glimpse these things, because your carnal mind is going to go tilt. It was just 2 years ago, you know, every August in where we live in Washington State, we go through, I don't know what belt it is, but there's shooting stars all the time. And I love going out watching that, because to me, when I look at the stars with all the lights on, that's God. I can communicate with God, commune. And all these things are flashing, you know, we see them on wrestling. Oh, you see that one? You missed it. You see? But beautiful. I love that. And the Lord nudged me and said, remember what I told you about you have authority. He was challenging me. And I went, okay. So I told Reshma, this is what God's doing. He's challenging me. So I said, okay, Father, in the name of Jesus, we command a shooting star to come here. Right here. Took about 1 minute, and exactly where I had pointed, whoosh, and we both went, whoa. And we sat out there another half hour, and I said, Lord, can I do one more? You said in the mouth of two or three witnesses, and I got, go ahead. I said, in the name of Jesus, I command another one to go this way, and instantly, whew. And I said, okay. I'm convinced. I understand, Lord. He was teaching me through his grace the authority he's actually given us that very few ever dare to even to contemplate, never mind grasp. It's grace. If you understand that you're light, if you get this, it will revolutionize everything in your walk with God. As he is, so are we in this world. He is light. Now, scripture says, be holy for I am holy. Holiness is a facet of the character of God. He could just as easily say, be light for I am light. Be love, for I am love. Any of the facets of his character, he can say, be this because this is who I created you to be, just like I am. So he's saying, be light, arise and shine, for your light has come. So I began to practice starting 3 years ago. It's been amazing what God's doing. Every morning, I choose to be clothed in the garment of light. It changes your world. A light, in the natural, light is actually electromagnetic radiation emanating from a source. And it extends in the color spectrum from red to violet. So it has a spectrum of color, of frequency, of brilliance. So do you. Both electromagnetic radiation in God, and that electromagnetic radiation is light, exist outside of time. You're an eternal being. God created time. You know why he created time? To put you through school. Neville teaches on that. He created this time frame to put you through a school so that you are prepared for eternity. This isn't even kindergarten compared to what the vastness of eternity holds for us. Isn't it interesting that light is one of the major features of near-death experiences? I laugh at that. That's the carnal mind trying to figure out a supernatural thing. So even though you've been dead 5 days, it was just near death. Because we can't do this coming back from dead thing. But the vast majority see light. They're drawn to a light. Why? Because God's light. All throughout scripture, the glory of God, he was so bright I couldn't look. I mean, God is light. If the Father himself stepped into this room in the fullness of his brilliance, of his character, it would vaporize.